How do they expect anyone to get in there? What the come on. I'm not a Houdini. I'm not a magician. Oh. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in. Today is Thursday, the 20th of April, 2023. Heading to a service call right now in Woodmere, which is in the part of the five towns in Nassau County on Long Island, in the great state of New York. They have a hot house. It's hot. And it's not the air conditioning that's not working properly. They got a hot house. Let's go see what's going on.
Anyone home?
Okay, one second.
Hello? Here for the heat. Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. It's not so hot now, is it?
The windows are open.
Is it still blowing out hot air?
Yeah.
Where's the,
Why come in the heat? Yeah.
I don't know. I guess maybe that's why I'm here. where's the furnace or boiler?
In the garage.
In the garage? Door number two? Yeah. All right. Looks like we are back there. Well, I don't know how you get back there, though. Man, it's hot as balls in here, I tell you that. Wow. Okay, looks like a Peerless. Gas boiler. It's hot as F in here, though. Damn. It's like a sauna. Africa. Sahara hot in here. All right. Let's see if I can squeeze my my tukas in there. Let's move the blach out of the way. Yeah, that's why you keep food warm on the Holy Sabbath. Oh, man. How the hell you get in here? Make a hole, right? We're going to make a hole and get in there. Let's check our zone valves. Apparently the first floor heat is hot like fire. Okay. We have some zone valves here. That one's calling. This one's not. That one's not. Let's see which one this is. Let's see what that is. All right, let's follow that pipe. Goes across here. Goes down there. Oh man, she's hot like fire. And I guess this is a return. That's hot too, right? Let's see what happens if I turn the power off to this bad boy. Oh, why would there be a switch here? That would be too complex, right? I wonder if it's stuck open. Regardless, we have a mess of wire here. So we have four wires coming out of this Honeywell zone valve. Two are for the end switch, which are the red wires. So the red wires, so when the motor activates with power by signal from the thermostat, the motor energizes and it powers a lever inside the zone valve, and it pushes down a little button, like a little nipple, right? And then when it pushes that in, that's the switch, which is here, right? So there's end switch one, here's end switch two. Now it's getting 24 volts by means of thermostat, all right? Let's just see if I can remove this wire, right? There's one of the two yellow wires. If I remove this wire, if it de-energizes, right, the zone valve, then we know we're getting we have an electrical issue here. So let's see if I can do that. So I separated the wire, all right? There's one, and there's two, all right? So that breaks the circuit, but I still have no resistance. The zone valve is stuck in the open position. We need a new zone valve installed there. That's what makes this channel different than everyone else's. I realize as part of a community, you people reading, and that's what happens, see? Situations like that make this channel different than all the other ones that are out there. As a viewer, sitting at a computer, sitting on your phone or tablet, it's a nice life. You guys can just watch whatever channel you want, but you guys choose to watch me because of things like that. Uncut, unedited, raw. Now that I have the right number, right, after calling my office, let's give them a call and let's see what they want
to
do.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
I can't win.
917627.
Let's try it again. You know, when calls go right to voicemail, you try again until they pick up. That's one of those cases right now.
Hello.
Hi, this is Mike from the Pipe Doctor.
Hi, how are you?
How are you? Yes. So, you're not home. At least they told me you weren't home.
I am. I'm coming in.
Oh, I'm in the garage.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Bye. 10 minutes.
Bye. See? That was easy.
Hi.
You?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. What's going on?
So the reason why the first floor is so hot is because the boiler was running heat for the first floor at the same time the air conditioning was running.
What? How's that?
There's a part in the boiler that's broken.
Okay.
So we need to replace the part in the boiler. Okay. And then you can close your windows and then you can have air conditioning again.
That was the problem.
Yes. That's why you have hot air blowing out of the vents and the air conditioning can't overcome that
is heat. There something in the back that you have to turn off when the heat versus...
No.
Because when we first moved in, I don't know, somebody passed by and said something's on.
Maybe the air conditioning was on while in the wintertime.
Which is... Well... Is there something that I have to turn?
No. Shouldn't be.
So then what was that?
What was what? I don't know. I didn't...
While you're here, then, can I ask you something?
Yes.
My filter system is off now.
What kind of filter system?
So
the water filter back there?
Yeah, I can't get this. I'm sorry that
they blocked everything into here?
Yeah, everything I clean it out, they just continue.
Okay.
So you're pretty thin, so...
thank you. My wife calls me a fat pig, but it's okay.
So this, I can't...
That's a hot water filter.
Right, I can't...
Yes.
And I can't open it, and I can't order the part that needs it.
Yes.
You also change that?
We can order the tool... You have the tool for it?
No, but they use a plier.
No. It's a tool that goes into little circles on the top ring.
He's a friend of mine from Brooklyn.
Okay, a friend doesn't mean he's doing any good. but there are circles on the top ring of that, little circles there, that you put a little tool in there. Well, it's a long tool, and you use that as the tool to take it off. Using a plier, you're crushing the ring. It's not going to work.
He said that this should just turn
with the rod that you need that goes inside the circle, and it's not that expensive, like $20. It's a little cheap little thing.
So can you get it?
We can order the part for you, yes, the tool, and you'll have it.
Can I go pick it up?
I normally order online. I have it in a day or two.
And when is the boiler thing part?
I could do it now. I'm just looking.
Yeah, you could do it now.
Yeah.
Okay, I just figured.
Right, here I am. I'm trying to get my fat tuchus in there. Oh, yeah. I gave her the price. She's like, what? I was like, why so expensive? Well, the part's in the truck, and that's the price. I was like, oh, can I get a break? No. Sorry. No. Here's his own valve. So, let me show you. I'm just going to take the cover off right here. Okay. And I'm gonna show you what I did over there. So here is the zone valve, which is in this orientation. Okay, we are pointing down. So we're like that, okay? Doesn't really make a difference at this point of the game, but there's a directional flow pointing down. If you look right here, here's a lever right here that this motor activates and it pushes in this little nipple right there. Listen very carefully, you'll hear it. See, so when the motor gets 24 volts, it turns, pushes that brass little lever on the gear, and as soon as it's fully energized, it pushes that closed, right? Closing the circuit and closing TT. That's how his own valve works. These die. That's why I keep four of them in the truck year round. So here we are in April 20th, and doing a heating service call while Daniel's installing a new central air conditioning system. Go figure. So I removed one screw there and another screw there, and we're gonna install this on the body over there, which is a very tight spot.
See how tight it is? She's tight. That's where it needs to go. And I'm gonna mount that, and then I'll do the wiring with you.
All right, so now that the screw right there, and then that screw is secure, now I will play with the lever and make sure that there's no difficulty moving this. If there's any difficulty moving that, you're gonna have to change the body, which is this brass thing right there, right? So now that that's good, we're gonna put the cover back on, and then we're gonna wire this bad boy up. And it's four wires, very easy.
So I have been squeezing myself. I feel like a sardine. I can't breathe. I've been squeezing myself past this 1-inch gas pipe for the past 15 minutes. And I was able to successfully put lipstick on a pig. Let me show you what I'm talking about. There's no easy way of making zone valve wiring nice and neat and pretty unless you're gonna use some conduit or some BX, sheathing, armored sheathing, and using a box, maybe with some offsets and getting the Benda out and put a little like 1900 box here. There's no other way of making this look pretty, especially when it's, you're starting to look with like, an abortion. But I tied in together all of my end switches, which are the red wires, my 24 volts. I use these Wagos. These are the little Wago 221s. These are basically, I'm gonna keep it real, glorified wire nuts. I think they look nice and pretty. You don't have to worry about twisting the solid wires together like you're supposed to when you're using solid wire. And it's good for troubleshooting because behind it you have terminals to test. So I have the Wago 5-conductor connector here, there, and then over here I use the coupling. Looks nice and pretty. Now, an easy way of testing to make sure that I'm all good is that I am gonna quickly, with some force, push open the zone valve lever. And when that switch pushes in the little nipple, that little switch right there, we'll hear something with the boiler. Ready? Here we go. Heard that for a second? So we know that the end switch wiring for that one is good. Let's try the second one. Not fast enough. Let's try that again. You ready? Let's try that again. Oh, now it's like, doesn't want to go. Now that one doesn't even want to go. That one's working freely. But this one over there, it's all demented in a little bit. It's slow. All right, it's special needs, let's see. All right, so that one's not doing anything. Let's take a look inside there and let's see if that zone valve is good or bad. Really? Oh God, I'm really squeezing in here right now. Okay, let's see. Let's see if we can see that little switch. Where is it? Try to zoom in. Right there. It's right there, you can't see it, but it's right there. I'm gonna see if I can push that in. Good. See, I'm pushing it in. I know you guys can't see it, and neither can I without the use of the eye. See? This is uncut, unedited, and raw. You're not getting that with those other YouTube plumbers out there. Along with me, Mikey Pipes. All right, to top off this job, to finish it up, let's do proper identification.
I can't read that, but that looks like 2FH. Right? That doesn't say anything. But that clearly says first floor.